It's me, Marissa, and today we are going to be talking about how to create a wisp effect with alcohol inks. This is one of my favorite techniques. It creates some really beautiful, vibrant effects with your pieces, and here are some examples. You can see they're all a little bit different, and I'm going to show you a couple of different ways where you can go about creating this technique for yourself. So let's see what we need. The first thing you need is isopropyl alcohol and a pipette. I prefer to use 91%, but you can experiment a little bit with other percentages. There's 99 and 70, but I just go with 91. You also need your inks. I'll be using Copic various ink refills today. If you want to use some metallics, I really like the Jacquard Piñata brass color, which is what I'll use today. And you need your paper. This is heavyweight Yupo paper, and heavyweight is extra important today because we will be using a heat gun. I prefer this Wagner heat gun. I've had it for a while and I like it quite a bit. It has a couple of different settings. And the important thing is to use heavyweight paper because that heat gun will warp the lower weights. So let's get started. So one of the ways to create a wisp effect is actually to start with an existing piece. In this piece, I used B23, BG10, and N7. I just kind of put some fades down there, but I'm not super thrilled with it. So you don't have to throw it away. Let's add some wisps and see what happens. See if we can make it a bit better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my pipette filled with isopropyl alcohol and I'm going to push it onto the paper in the direction where I'd like a fade. And I'm going to be starting where I see some focal points, which is these two spots that I just pointed at. So let's give it a try. I'm going to fill up my pipette. I'm going to go to one of those focal points and push the ink, the alcohol onto the paper, allowing that ink to spread with the alcohol. And one of the things that you want to make sure and do is allow that paper to touch a paper towel underneath to allow that alcohol to go onto the paper towel and break that surface tension so we don't get a buildup of the ink and the alcohol on the sides. So I'm going to be taking my heat gun now, and in a very slow and steady motion, I'm going to be pushing that ink and drying it into the corner. And you can see here that we have some really beautiful lines, but we also have these lines around the edges, which aren't quite as pretty. That's why I usually cut these pieces of paper a little bit large so I can trim that off in the end. So let's put another wisp down. I'm picking that focal point again, pushing that alcohol onto the paper, picking up my heat gun and pushing the alcohol with the ink towards the corner of the paper, making sure that the paper is making contact with the paper towel so that the residual ink and alcohol has somewhere to go. Sometimes when you're putting the alcohol onto the paper, you will get these spots that just won't quite be covered by the alcohol. You can see that there. You want to make sure that that entire area is covered so that that ink can go anywhere it would like. So I fix that by kind of swirling around the ink and the alcohol together in that corner and making sure that those spots that were still dry were filled in by the alcohol. So again, I'm just taking that heat gun and I'm moving and drying the ink into the corner and creating some really beautiful lines and fades. So you can see that since these were some lighter colors, our fades aren't very dramatic. So let's see if we can add in a little bit more color with some more density. So I took some of that beautiful blue, put it at that focal point, and I'm going to do the exact same thing again. I'm going to be taking that alcohol, putting it over the ink, and moving it to the corner of the page. Again, taking that heat gun in a slow, steady, and consistent motion, and making sure that all that ink and alcohol can be absorbed by the paper towel. So you can see we got a little bit more of a dark blue there. Whoop! We got more of a dark blue there, but still not super dense. So let's see what happens in the lower half of the paper. We have a little bit more gray going on there, a bit more stacking and layering. So let's see what happens when we hit that with the heat gun. Very, very pretty. So you can see that those existing points of the ink where there were those dried edges, stuck to the paper a bit more and created those extra lines. You can see that there. One thing to keep in mind when you're using this effect is that you don't have to have one point where all these fades come out to make it almost look like a star. You can do that and it is really fun, but you can also pick another point. For example, I'm going to pick that lower dark spot as a second focal point and start some wisps going out from that point. So you can see I put the alcohol on that darker spot and pushed it into that corner to create an almost stacking effect. This creates a lot of intrigue and a bit more of a sense of movement, and it's really fun. It's kind of tricky because you need to plan a little bit more about what you want to look like it's in the background and what you want to be in the foreground, but either way, it's incredibly fun. And that's a great way where you can go about using an old piece that you thought you were going to get rid of and making something really new and incredible with it. So let's say you want to just start right off the bat by creating a wisp piece. These are two pieces where I did that, and you can see this one on the left is a bit softer, and the one on the right has quite a few more dark lines. It's a bit more intense. So I'm going to show you two different ways where you can create a softer wisp effect and a wisp effect that's a little bit bolder. So let's start with two pieces of Yupo paper, and I'll be showing you these two different ways where you can get a soft and a more intense look with your wisps. So let's go ahead and start with some inks. I lost the cap of this guy, but I'm using V09, which I believe is violet, and I'll also be using N7. So let's start with the more intense look. Let's take one of our pieces of Yupo paper and take that beautiful purple color and just put one small drop down in the center of that Yupo paper. At this point, if you want to add some metallics, you can take just a little bit in a pipette and add it to the ink that is on the paper. So what I'm going to do, similar to the last example, is take a pipette filled with that isopropyl alcohol, and I'm going to be pushing it onto the ink in the direction I want the ink to flow. So I'm showing you a bit there about how you want to continue to move your hand as you push that ink. There we go. And then you want to make sure again to have that paper touch the paper towel so that you can get some of that runoff to absorb into the paper towel and not build up on your piece. So again, I'm taking that heat gun, pushing the ink and drying it out into the corner. So this is already looking pretty similar to how we were using the existing piece with the ink already on it, but what we're going to be doing now is actually picking where we want to add these focal points and having a bit more of consistency because we're choosing where all these bits of ink are going. So again, I decided to put an additional fade at the lower half, and I'm going to do that again, but with even a bit more ink. And this time around, I want it to be much darker. So what I'm going to do is put that ink down onto the Yupo paper, and I'm actually going to dry the ink as it is without any isopropyl alcohol touching it. This allows the ink to really dry and form together and stick to the paper a little bit more intensely when we add that alcohol, and less of it will end up running off onto the paper towel. So now that that's pretty dry, I'm going to choose to push that up with some alcohol. So just adding a little bit of that, and you can see we're already getting some really beautiful lines of that ink and getting that really intense and bold look that we're going for. So sorry I go to the bottom of the camera here a little bit, but I'm pretty much doing the exact same motion where I'm taking that heat gun, pushing it up, and you can see we're already getting some really amazing lines there. So let's show that again. Hopefully a little more in the camera this time. So I'm taking that pipette, pushing the ink up into the corner, allowing the paper to touch the paper towel and soak up that residual ink and alcohol, and then taking the heat gun and in a very steady and pointed motion, drying the ink out towards the corner of the paper. Alcohol inks are really interesting in how they're able to just create this amazing effect with just heat. So you can see that we have some amazing lines here and some beautiful textures, and you can do this all the way around the ink or the paper if you want. Let's just do one more fade down here in the corner with that existing purple. And one thing I want to show is, let's say we don't want this one to be quite as intense and bold, you can see that I took my glove and I actually loosened the ink there a little bit so that it was able to mix a bit more with that alcohol, and now you can see we have a much more consistent and smooth fade instead of getting those strong lines that comes from the ink just being pretty stuck to the paper already. So that's how you create some more intense lines to have a piece with a lot of character and a lot of boldness. But let's talk a bit more now about how we want to create a softer piece. You can see here that the lines don't go all the way to the edges. You have a nice fade, for example, where we have these dark central points with the blue moving out to almost the whiteness of the paper. So let's talk about how to do that. So let's take another piece of heavyweight Yupo paper with our isopropyl alcohol, and this time we're actually going to be starting by putting the alcohol down first, which is, flip it over. There we go, one of the advantages of Yupo paper. So we're gonna put the isopropyl alcohol down first, which is the only time almost that I ever do this. So you can see a little bit in the reflection there that I put the alcohol down in a way that looks like it's kind of a wisp already. So I added the ink to that central focal point with some of the gold that on top of the alcohol, and I'm actually going to fold that paper into almost a taco shape, and I'm moving the alcohol around with the ink. And this is a technique of patience. You don't have to move quickly, you don't have to swirl it around a lot, just allow that ink to move around until you get a really beautiful gradient that you're happy with. And one of the advantages here is that as you're moving it around, you can just kind of touch a point to the paper towel to soak up some of that residue. You don't have to have it continuously in contact with the paper towel, similar to the other effects. So you can see here that we have a really pretty fade that I'm getting pretty happy with. This purple color, I believe it's violet, just creates these fades just exceptionally. So you can see I have that nice dense area with the really dark rich purple moving out into that beautiful really bright color. Now I'm going to use my heat gun, but only to dry the fade. I don't want to add any lines, I just want it to be dry. So you can see that we have a little bit of color staining with the paper, and that's okay, that happens with some colors and it's part of just working with inks. So let's make another fade. So we're going to take that alcohol again, and we're going to start at that focal point and move the alcohol out into the corner and make sure we get that whole area wet. And then we're going to put a little drop of ink near the focal point, and we're going to also add just a little bit of metallic there. And then we're going to start to move that alcohol in and near the ink and vice versa. So you can see I'm just taking my time and making sure that all of that ink mixes with the alcohol and creates a nice consistent fade. So what happens sometimes is you may need to add a little bit more alcohol if it's not quite moving very well, and that's okay. So this is going to help it move a little bit faster and get a nice consistent fade. And the good news about this is you can also go back and forth a couple of times. You can kind of see which way you like the density of the ink to sit at, whether you want it more on the right or the left, or even push it in towards the focal point a little bit more like I did just there. Now I'm going to take my heat gun again and just dry that fade. And now we have two beautiful fades. And one of the fantastic things about this effect is you can combine your technique a little bit. So now I'm going to just take the alcohol and start in that focal point and push out into the corner. And you'll see that alcohol pick up some of that existing purple and start to create a whole nother fade and also a really beautiful straight line on that existing fade. So again, I'm just kind of moving that ink around until I get a nice gradient that I'm happy with. And then I'm going to take my heat gun again and dry it one more time. And now we've already built this beautiful composition with three fades. So now let's add a smaller fade. Let's add some isopropyl alcohol on top of the fade we just did and try and see if we can get a little bit more of an intense line. So you can see I added much less isopropyl alcohol onto a point that was already very dense with ink. And that ended up creating this really beautiful line. So those are a few ways where you can start a piece. One thing I just want to make sure and say again is to remember to keep your heat gun consistent. You want to make sure and keep it in one spot as you push the ink, because that is what forces the ink to form those really beautiful lines. So there's a few examples of how you can create this effect. It is an advanced technique, so be patient, but have fun and experiment with it. And best of luck and happy creating, friends. To be free, it's like it's always what you like. It's always what you like. Why it's always what you like. It's always what you like.